perfected, whatever. That's not what I want. Like, I don't want that, because the perfection part is what causes the stress, and then that's, the stress causes the headaches, and then the headaches causes anxiety, or it could be like, fuck the headache, it just goes straight to anxiety. So it's like, I don't want that. So I'm not about to put myself in that situation. So I rather just think about the workout rather than the food. So I don't even care about the workout. Like, it's like, okay, get the workout in. Get it in, baby. Get it in, Tay. Get it in. So, when I can, I try to get it in. You know, that's why I do the mini workouts. I'm always thinking about my body, though. Like, I think about how it's balanced and what it looks like and all these different things. So, then I, what else? It's like, what I'm trying to say is, like, I don't want perfection. It's like, because I have all these, like, other things going on in my mind. Not to say, I don't know if I'm crazy. I don't know. But it's like, I've always had these issues. And it's like, I don't want to have the issues. I just don't. I don't want to have them. So in order for me not to have the anxiety about it, or not for me to feel like I'm pleasing somebody else besides myself. Oh, that's what I was talking about, feminism. So in order for me to get there, I have to do it my way. Like, I don't need to do it your way. I don't need to think about how you think about it. I need to do it my way. That's when I came to the conclusion that we don't tell enough people you have to be healthy. Because I've been around some thin people, and you be like, man, let's do this. And they can't even breathe. You know what I'm saying? They got the best body. You just like, but you can't even fucking breathe. And then people would have the nerve to be like, you fat. They would like, call somebody fat. When I say fat, I really do mean like, you can be skinny and fat. Like, you can actually be a skinny person, but you have issues, like, you fat. And I'm fat, like, fat. Like, I'm talking about fat, like, you got high blood pressure. You got diabetes. You got... and this was skinny and heavier people, but usually it's like heavier people get flack about it, and they ain't even close to being like, I'm probably not even close to being unhealthy. And then like, somebody will bring up, like, if I go to the doctor, like, oh, but your cholesterol, then I look at the numbers and my cholesterol ain't even fucking near being too high, you know. But they're like, well, my cholesterol, I ate vegetables for, like, you know, I haven't eaten this, you know, vegetables for a long time. You mean my cholesterol is, like, that bad right now? You know, like, so it's like they'll bring up something, and then they don't say to you, they used to tell me when I went to doctors, like, you have to lose weight. It's like, why? Like, what am I losing weight for? And then I'm telling you, when I lost the weight, I was just like, I was happy, but I was unhappy. Happy to unhappy, because first off, I got attention, but it wasn't something that was fulfilling. Like, it wasn't loving. It wasn't, it was more like, oh, you look good. Let me do this for you because you look good. You know, like, it's when in, the, I think on the other side of that, it's like the man is with you because he's attracted to you and you feel warm and all this different stuff. So it was like a false sense of security. It was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just did not, even that wasn't right. So what I'm saying is, like, so many people, I thought, man, I need to lose weight after I have a kid. And I mean, I felt so insecure. Like, I felt so defeated. The lady would call me like, you want to do dating with breakfast? What is it? Lunch for a date? I was like, nah, I ain't doing that. Then I thought about it. I'm going to do it when I get my taxes. You know, it's like, you want to do lunch? No, I can't do it because I'm so fat. You know, I gained so much weight. But at the same time, y'all, I'm still healthy. And so that's what made me think about it. I was like, I don't need to be doing it. Like, I'm pretty sure if I just stick to being a vegan or a vegetarian and working out, it'll probably come off, you know. And I mean, I was doing that for what, months? I was like working out and still eating, and nothing came, like, it's just, I'm solid. And the thing is like, if I lose 15 pounds, I would be a totally different range of my purse of who I am right now. And that is crazy. Like, that's what I noticed too. Like, when I was at 215, I'm like one size, and if I lose 15 pounds, I'm like in a whole other, like, medium size. And it's like, I don't know, I don't think I looked right either. I just don't think I did. And now I don't look right to myself sometimes. I'm like, my head don't fit my body. I don't, you know, it's like, what is wrong with me? But yeah, I just, I don't know, I feel like I could do it, but at what cost? And at whatever cost that is, I want it to be a healthy cost where I feel healthy and I'm doing it because I really like the food and not because, you know, and the workout and not because somebody was like, oh, you got to, yeah, that what you going to do. You know, it's like, you don't look good. You know, just hearing somebody say that, like, but I do. I look great. I feel great. I took my clothes off and it's like, I still got my shape. Like, oh my God, girl. Like, I'm looking at myself like, you still solid. Like, you still got that thick solid to you. And you fucking 41 fucking years. You got it. You still got your solid. You know, you still, you know, it's like, I look at my titties. I didn't want my titties since I used to work out on my chest. I know people be, you know, if y'all heard the shit I used to talk about, but see, I was serious. Like, I ain't playing. I used to work out on my chest because I was like, shit, I don't want no saggy ass titties. I could actually take off my bra. They gonna be there, but they still beautiful. You know, like, they still got that sag and hook to them or something like that. But, you know, it ain't perfect, but it's good enough for me. And so all the stuff that I want to accomplish for myself, that's what happened. So that's where my feminism came from. It was like, my feminism came from the strength of myself. Like, just looking at myself and being like, you know what? You the shit, girl. Like, for real, look at you. Like, you haven't, look at your mind. Like, you've been through some fucking shit where you would think that I'm fucking retarded. Like, I'm like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't even no credit. I'm like, I had to question myself a couple times. Am I autistic? Shit, am I retarded or something? Like, do I see this situation correctly, you know? And I don't know. It's like, I just, you know, I had to wake up from it. And it's like, okay, well, after you woke up, you a whole nother motherfucker, you know? Like, so it's like, I don't know, but that's where my feminism comes from. It comes from, like, I have been through a lot of shit. And it's like, nah, bitch, you ain't finna sit up here and tell me. Then, you know what, people, they love to be like, well, now you've been through all this stuff. You've been hurt so many times. But I haven't. I've been loved, too. You know, like, because there's so many times you recall the pain. Like, sometimes you be like, oh, my God, the pain. And it's like, but that person loved me sort of like what I wanted to be loved. I loved him sort of like he wanted to be loved. You know, so it's almost like, okay, well, I can't just be like, all people ain't shit and all stuff like that. So that's when I come to the part where, no, I know what love is. I know what a good relationship is. I know what marriage is. But I also know what a fucked up one is, too. And you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I was telling my son, I was like, I'm so happy that in my life I wasn't, like, truly a hoe. You know, like, I done been through some hoe situations, but, you know, ho. So it's like, that's when I started noticing what the fuck is going on. And then, but the innocence of it was, is that I didn't really notice because I had to notice because I was like, what the fuck is, you know, like, what's going on with this situation? When I found out, you know, something happening, I don't know, whatever it is, apps or whatever, I don't know what y'all got, but I had to know about it because it was like, you know, the pattern wasn't right. You didn't have all these good relationships, and then all of a sudden, now everything gonna go downhill. It's like, nah, something wrong, something going on, and somebody trying to make you feel insignificant or less than what you are. And it's like, no, baby, you not. You are something beautiful to behold. And so that's the other thing that led me to it. It's like, all the time somebody want to take that away from me, take my character, take my you know what I'm saying, take who I am, take everything I am, like, you know, take it and be like, okay, yeah, you ain't shit when you did this, then you did that, fuck you, you ain't shit, then you did that, fuck you, you ain't shit. That ain't some shit you do. That ain't in the Bible. That ain't this. Y'all, please. I don't care. I still gotta live my life. And I cannot be, like, pushed down for every fucking wrong thing I do. Because I'm telling you, if I did something wrong, I probably didn't already repented for it, prayed about it, done every fucking thing I could do to just, like, be like, okay, you all right. You know, and I don't know, just to even get to that point, it's like, I know that the person that's standing in front of me is real, is correct, and is honest. As honest as I can be. As honest as I can be. As honest as I can be. And so, I don't know, I really, my feminism. So she said, you can't pick and pull, that was her thing. it could have been a guy though, because it sounded like a guy talking for real, trying to be a girl. So it's like, you can't pick and pull what parts away or whatever. And yes, you can, because that's my feminism. Because I always think about how I always like to take care of somebody, like, and I do, like, it's just me, I'm not changing it. Like, she said in the thing, she was like, that's how we were raised. I'm like, this bitch is a warrior, she need to fucking go to war, because bitch, I ain't you, I ain't finna be fighting my whole fucking life. I don't need that, you know, like, it's like my whole life fighting, just keep fighting. I ain't even trying to fight now, motherfuckers be trying to fight, I ain't even in the fight. Like, you having a fight with me, and you don't even need to have a fight with me. Like, you upset with me, why? You keep explaining the rules to me, and I don't give not two fucks. You see what I'm saying? Man, I'm telling y'all, that's why I be like, that's that fucking white boy. Man, that boy, he, everything a rule, and he be the main motherfucker stealing. The main motherfucker cursing somebody out. You know what I'm saying? You like, nigga, I just saw you do this shit. How the fuck you gonna now explain the rules to some motherfucking body else? Calling the police. You know, like, this nigga crazy. He forever has some fucking problem. So anyway, what else? Like, my feminism, you know, like, it's like being my being a woman. Like, I remember I used to feel the same way. I cut my hair off, and then it's like, oh my god, she gay. So then it's like, you kind of make up for it. You just make up because somebody criticized you for being gay. No, guess what? I do the other thing. I just try to figure out, am I gay? You know, so I try to figure out, am I gay? And I'm not gay. You know, I'm not gay at all. Y'all, I for real was like, I thought I was gay. Can't touch a woman. You hear me? I can't even. It's like, I don't even. I'm just not there. It's just not in me. Just not in me. So, I don't know. It's like my own feminism. I just, that's what I like. My own feminism. And the way I move and dance and all this different stuff. I don't know if I look right. I don't know if it's goofy. I don't give not two fucks. Like I said, I done been through too much shit to be like, you are not gonna live your fucking life. Because I am. I'm gonna live my fucking life. Every fucking day. Like, it's like, it ain't even a joke right now. I'm gonna live my fucking life. And I don't know. And that's why it's like, I can see, but I can't see. And everything coming apart and just like, just not even, it, this shit so far apart. Like, it's crumbled. You know, it's crumbled. And all I see is like, that's just a chance to pick that shit up and eat it with a spoon. I don't know. Like, I don't know what the fuck else to do. You know, I don't know what else to do. So, that's it. And it's all because of my writing. I wrote the one about, like I said, all my writings, and I don't know who behind it, but I still don't like you. I don't, and you ain't got to like me either, but it's not right for you to take my writings and then try to use them against me. You know, that shit ain't cool. Everything I say, we're gonna declare it, we're gonna make it so that it's the right situation, and it's my shit. Like, you don't know what I mean. You don't know what I meant. That's why I didn't feel right. It's my shit. So how the fuck you gonna feel like that's something that you could do? It's not up to you. It's up to me. So, I don't know. And I don't want to be around people that don't want me around. You know? You don't want me around? I can go. I don't have no problem with it. I don't like that. I don't know. I wish Jamie would want me around. Jamie Foxx, be my friend. Come on, just be my friend then. Just be my friend, so I can pretend like I don't like you and then try to be in a relationship with you at the same time. Why you tell me that you don't even see me like that? Oh. Yep, that's what I want. I just want to go through that. Yep, I just with you. I just do for like, let's do it for like until we pass away. Just me. You don't need to talk to nobody. You don't need to be nobody else's friend but my friend. Let me just make up the situation. Don't do me like that. No, be my friend. Be my friend. I try to like somebody else. I just keep bragging on you. Like, man, that's like, you could be my friend and then I know you already done everything you probably want to do, and but still, I just want to be like, yep, that's my friend. And then brag about you some more. And then show them stuff that you've done. And then start show them stuff that I've done. And then that's how it's gonna be, because you're my friend, my best friend. It's too far, I know. He is like, I'm